to good always wins, except this time good will always lose because I'm playing. So, in order to kill the final boss of the first stage or the first dungeon, it will be quite hard. So, you can go for physical damage or stress damage. It works very well. But, sadly, I'm not using a meta build, I'm not using a cheese party or a party cheese. These are just my favorite minions in the game and I'm using them almost correctly. Move those I'll show you what I have on them because they have some really special items. Because they have the special items are the new minion unique items or artifacts, and Eretus has some good items as well. But for now, let's just worry about what they will do. Let's put her on hold. They finally made a character who can withstand his attacks, and that's very good. So let's put the cloud over there. By the way, he heals when he deals damage. That's an artifact. Okay, let's put him into the stands. Ouch. Well, that ruins my plan. She also ignores the ward, so she can drag him forward a little bit. And let's begin the slow grind. Sadly, this guy is way too overpowered. He should only be able to attack the first two lines from his position. Oh no, he attacks the whole lines from any position. And if he gets in front, it's even worse. Oh, you don't want to know what he deals in front. He will use that big crossbow to actually hurt everyone. So let's see, he didn't use a buff, so I'll not use her ultimate ability. Hey, again, more Hero Mania. That's a good amount of stress damage. Sadly, now he'll begin to AoE them. And be sure to leave that over there. She can no longer hit the final line of the enemy, so that's why I had to kill one of the minions anyway. And a lot of changes were made to the minions, so if you're not playing the current version or if you think a build will work from the previous versions, well, think again. Hello, Ster. The chance of him redirecting is way too high. I think it should be something like 20%. Is it time? No, it's not time. So let's put a ward and next turn we'll heal her. Yeah, usually he goes for the Dark Knight or the Lich, but this time he felt like going for the Bride of Aretus, I don't know why. That was very cruel and mean of him. Move those mortal legs. He doesn't do that much stress damage, but we have him at a half point now. Now, let's see. I hope this is a critical attack. It's not even a critical attack, oh, come on, game. That was sadly not a lot of damage for them. Now, it's very important to have the right items on your minions, otherwise you'll get very unlucky. Also, this guy is a cheater. Most of the times you'll not even use the correct items. Or the correct skills. So sometimes you'll just lose because he chooses to hit you with a crossbow 5 times in a row. And there's nothing you can do about it. Strength through pain. So one of them will get damaged. Yes. And now she'll get healed. It's a slow process and sometimes yeah you lose, but I don't know, if you don't use a cheese build or if you don't know how to play the game in general, this guy is the worst enemy here. Of course with some other builds he's easy, but some other stress builds will not be good for the next boss. Oh, that's a huge critical. They should really tone down those criticals and also that should be blocked. A 48 critical, that's okay. Just to heal the poor leech. think it would be this easy. Okay, so we got a bit lucky here, but again, there is not much you can do about it. Okay, that was a kind of like a lucky kill, I have to be honest. Step
towards my eternal kingdom.
Skin of the Alabaster, that's not so good. Okay, let me show you my build. I failed the fight a couple of times, but I just went back to the main menu and restarted it. I also didn't use any special artifacts because I forgot, so in a way you could have played this a lot better. This would have been so much better used on this boss. Also, of course, let me see. Yeah, this could have been also a bit better. But now, thanks to the old items you can find, it's actually easier to make a build with whatever part you have laying around. So the Bride of Arietus, Wedding Gift. Critical damage is increased by 50%. That's a huge amount. Also, she gets more luck and more critical. So let me show you why it's so good. Also, she has the Sharpen Bone, Ignore Wards and Blocks. And the Soul Gem. So that's why she dealt so much stress damage. The Bull Skull, this is not only a temporary item, I don't have anything better to give him. I think I'll maybe give him the skin of the Alabaster or the armor plates, I don't know. Vampire Fangs, so if you're using a build that deals a lot of damage, this is also very good. But his cloud actually heals him each time he passes damage or he does damage. And he has the Heart of Emptiness, which is an excellent item. He basically gets all the mana and rage for being attacked. Also another Bull Skull, just to help with the healing. And their abilities are quite high. So the stats are something like this, 12 armor and 9 resistance. I'm just waiting to give him something a little better, maybe some HP, because with the new stat system, it's actually a lot better to upgrade them. I also didn't get anything special for the others. So her biggest weakness are probably physical attacks or magic attacks. That's give her a ward or something. Actually a block, because she can get wards and that's the max she can get from the Lost Soul. And Mr. Iraitus had a bit of luck with these things, the spell power and all of that, but usually he will not be level 16 when he reaches that fight, depending on your items and your specific build. And also I use a lot of the Blood Curse because it gives me more vampires. And I used a lot of vampires for some menial tasks. For example, I used the vampire here to put her to work. I also sacrificed a few vampires, one or two, on the map. For those Altar of Sacrifices, so that's how I got some items. So I didn't use a lot of items just on building monsters. Also, if you are interested where I got those items, it's from the cultist. The cultist will give you minion specific items. So always search for those in the first dungeon. The mines, that is. The exit. Come on, exit. Glorious Respite. As you can see, I think they got a little healing. So, even though they made the dungeons longer, you still have a hard time gathering the souls. So, I really recommend you build and upgrade this obelisk for the digger souls. Otherwise, it will be very hard for you to upgrade everything until you finish the game. As you can see, they kind of need 50 each time they upgrade at the second level. So, even though it's... it'll be very rough, I'll just have to upgrade that even more. And some other tips for this, as usual, just have fun with the game. If you don't have fun with the game, you'll never go anywhere big. So let me show you what I can do here. The cultist, the Altar of Sacrifice, I can sacrifice the vampires. Sadly, I didn't get a lot of vampires in the first dungeon, I should have gotten a lot more. Also the Digger Souls, okay, that's nice, a good candidate. Cold Spring. Yeah, that might be the one I choose. Sadly, there's no Iretus experience, so the cultist is kind of like my first pick for this. Oh, actually, two sets of cultists, sacrifice. Oh, this is actually turning out to be a lot better. Just look at all the buffs I can get if I go to the left. Yeah, try to plan your route for the things you need. Of course, you have to fight the dwarves first. The chest is good, but the artifacts for Aeretus, I don't think they are so good anymore. You just have to buff up your minions to a very, very high degree. I'll also avoid that elite squad battle, so I don't have to do the battle. Well, the last one should be okay. And I also get a heal before the final boss. That's amazing. The left one it is then. So, as for the creation aspect, I don't really create any more minions except the ones that I need in my graveyard. And I'm just waiting for another alchemy buff, probably. Using distillation, that's also pretty good. And summoning the shade is kind of like a bad idea because I don't want anyone to die, but you can use, for example, three vampires and the shade if you want to have a damage train before and then come with your main party. You can also leave the battle anytime you want, so don't forget about that. Otherwise, the game is kind of far, so yeah, be very careful and upgrade each time you have the possibility. That's why they have so many stat points. And they are basically the first two are tanks. She is not a tank, but she dies kind of... It's actually pretty hard to beat as well. Yeah. Anyway, see you next time when I fight the dwarves. I'll actually be finishing the game on YouTube. Bye.